Errol, can I talk to you right now? Thank you. Errol, I'd really want you to take care of Janice in Malaysia. Will you watch over her for me? Janice always ends up in a fight. A Malaysian might get on her nerves. Then she'll be in trouble.
What trouble?
Did she tell you how we met in Barcelona? We were both in a DVD shop and we're looking for the same movie. But I got the last copy and then some really nasty blows from her.
That sure sounds like our Janice.
But she cries a lot too.
Yes, I know. I've seen her cry so many times, Wacky. I think the worst was when you two had a fight. But now, are you both okay?
Yes. We're doing just fine. Besides, she promised she will wait for me. Even for 3 years.
She did? You know you're very lucky to have her.
Yes, I know. So please take care of her for me. Because I love her so much. You'll do it as her friend, right?
You can count on me.
Wacky, hey, what are you doing here?
Nothing. I just want to spend every minute of my stay here with you.
What? But I will be working today. What are you going to do? Please don't say you'll watch me while I work.
Sure I can.
Hey, that's silly. No, I won't let you do that. I wouldn't be able to do my job if you're watching my every move.
But why not?
Why don't you just come back for me later?
Oh, that's right. You've resigned from your other job. But can we go out later tonight?
All right, sure, sure.
Okay?
Okay.
Great. Goodbye.
Bye, take care. Mm.
So, who's it from?
What?
Who is it?
Oh, no, it's my father. He said he wants to tell me something aside from asking where I am.
You know what? I think your father is a really nice man. What's wrong? Is there a problem?
Well, there's something that I'll have to tell you.
What is it?
You see, it's about my father. He is not really my father.
What?
But it's not really any problem. In fact, they've even told my siblings, so...
Yes, but do you know who your real father is?
My mother said that it is no longer important for me to know who my real father is. And besides, he died a long time ago.
Well, that's true, Janice. But then, is that it? Don't you want to know who he is? Janice, if I were you, I would do anything just to know who my real father is.
What for, Wacky? We are just doing fine, okay?
Janice, are you sure?
Mm-hmm.
You're okay with it?
Melba?
Oh.
Good news. I already got a job at the Globe Business Center as a customer service representative.
Oh, really?
Yes.
You know, I was able to sell all my goods too and even got more orders.
I believe that our luck has finally turned, Melba. This is the start of a better life. My prayers have been answered.
Melba?
Gardo? What are you doing here?
I was here the other night as well.
So my eyes didn't play a trick on me then. What do you want with me?
Melba, I want you to know that I regret every wrong thing I've done to you in Barcelona.
It's all in the past. It's over,
Melba,
please.
No, listen to me.
We have nothing to discuss, Gardo. And how did you find out where I live?
Well, I followed Wacky.
Wacky? Are you two related?
Wacky is my son.
What? Wacky is your son?
Why? What's wrong?
Nothing. You may leave now.
Melba, please, I only want to explain what really happened to us in Barcelona.
You don't have to explain anything to me. And I love the life I have with my husband. So please, leave me alone. I don't ever want to see your face again.
Who is that man with you in those pictures? Well, why are you two hugging each other? Just tell me the truth. Are you gay? Well?
You're right. You're right, I'm gay. And that's my boyfriend. In the
boyfriend?
What?
Hey,
are
Roman,
you crazy?
Stop it!
You disgust me!
Enough, Roman!
Shame
stop
on you, Paolo!
Enough! Just stop
You're
it!
You're a freak, and there's no freak in
How
this family!
How dare you say that, Roman! I'm telling you, he's twice the man you'll ever be! Do you know why that is? Because Paolo is responsible. He's dependable. He has principles. You have nothing. None.
Will you stay out of this, Trish? This is none of your business.
Roman, Trish is right.
Fine, go ahead, defend him. Just gang up on me.
We will, because you're wrong. To me, it doesn't matter whether your brother is gay or not. What's important is that he is a kind person, unlike you. So please spare us.
Shut up, Cherry. I don't care what you say. At least I know who I really am, a real man. And don't you talk back to me, you hear? You're just my wife.
Stop it! Enough!
Stop it! What's wrong with you?
You're a man? You really call yourself a man? You have no ambition whatsoever, and you even beat your wife? You always depend on others for all of your needs. And you always blame other people for your own mistakes. Is that really what you call a man, Roman? Is that what you call a real man? Is it?
Grandmother, are you angry with me?
Oh, why should I be angry with you?
Because I'm gay.
It really doesn't matter to me, my dear. You're my grandson. I've raised you, and I know that I've raised you right.
Did you know what my co-workers at the Globe Business Center told me? That I can sell prepaid cards right here at our home. You don't need to leave the house just to earn, Melba. Isn't that great? Why are you so quiet? Is there a problem?
You know I've never kept secrets from you, right? I have told you everything that has happened in my life.
That's true. So what's wrong?
It's Gardo. Earlier he waited for me outside. He wanted to speak to me, but I told him to leave.
But how did he find out where you were staying?
Through Wacky. Roger, Wacky is his son.
Mother, father.
Janice?
Good evening to you both.
Good evening, too. Sir, I made sure Janice got home safe.
Wacky, when are you leaving for Barcelona?
I'm leaving next week.
Well then, that's good. Excuse me.
Did you eat already?
Yes, sir, we have.
Oh, we're good. We've had dinner, Father, but what happened to Mother? Is she sick or something?
She hasn't been feeling well all day. So did you get my text message?
Mm-hmm.
I already got a job.
Really, Father?
Wacky?
Hmm? Father.
Have you already met Janice's parents?
Yes, I have. I've already met her father, Roger. He's such a funny man and a nice guy.
How about her mother?
Oh, you mean Melba. Well, she's a bit strict, but she is also very nice. I just noticed that even if they're not rich at all, they're a very happy family. So, why are you asking?
Oh, nothing. I'm just curious.
Janice?
Yes, Mother?
So tell me, when are you leaving for Malaysia?
We'll leave the week after next, I think. That's the fourth batch where Bless and I belong to. But if they release the results of our medical exam saying we pass, then we'll leave earlier. We might leave at the same time as the third batch. That's next week already.
That is good then.
Why do you ask?
Well, I'd really like to ask a big favor from you. Is it okay if you could stop meeting with Wacky, since you're busy with the papers for your job?
But why is that?
Please, Janice, will you just listen to me? Trust me. Come on, let's go. Goodbye.
Careful on your way.
Bye.
Thanks, buddy. Thank you so much. I'll just borrow it again next time. All right, then. Bye.
Jomar, please wait. Can we talk for a while, please?
And what's there to talk about? I mean, didn't you break up with me?
Jomar, can we please at least be friends?
What about Lee? Isn't he your boyfriend?
It's not what you think.
What we had is in the past. Let's forget about that and move on. That way no one will get hurt and no one will get disappointed. It will be better for both of us if we try to forget we met each other.
Melba?
Didn't I tell you to stay away from me?
I just need to speak with you, Melba.
We have nothing to talk about, Gardo. Just leave me alone.
I will continue to come here until you agree to listen to what it is I have to say.
Just leave me alone!
No, I won't.
Do you want me to call the police?
Go ahead. I'm not doing anything wrong. All I want is to speak with you. Just listen to me once, please. And I promise I won't bother you again. I promise.
My brother left us. He took his wife Cherry with him. And my nephew.
I can't believe your brother had the guts to leave this house.
He said that he finds it repulsive that the money I've been sending them comes from my Spanish boyfriend. Trish, he just has no idea how hard it is for me to work day and night in Barcelona. He doesn't know the hardships I went through just so I can send some money to them. Trish.
Paolo, stop thinking about him. Listen to me. Don't waste your time. You don't need him.
Trish, he may be a lot of things, but he is still my brother.
Tell me, did he treat you like a brother, Paolo? Huh?
You didn't have to look for me. You and Gigi are happy together. I have seen you two enjoying yourselves. If it were someone else, Gardo, I could have forgiven you. But you had to go and sleep with my best friend?
Despite what you saw, I didn't betray you. Sure, you and I had a big fight. Because I still didn't want to go back home. I wanted to earn some more. I wanted to save for our future. And just look, had you stayed just a bit longer, you would have also inherited money from our boss. And that money was what we, Gigi and I, used to start a new business. and we got lucky it succeeded.
So, you did end up with Gigi, just as I thought. And she's Wacky's mother?
Yes. But that was all because I felt abandoned. I felt so alone. Gigi stood by me. I got her pregnant. I did what was right. That's why I married her.
Then do the right thing again. Stay with her and your family, because you can never have me again.
She only seduced me, but you're the one I really love.
Gardo, I don't love you anymore. I love Roger now. He's the one who changed my life. He was the one there for me when I got back. Believe me, I owe him so much, and I do love him even more now. He's the father of my children. He's my husband. I have a family, and you have your own, so please, Gardo, let this be our last meeting. Don't keep your hopes up because you will only be disappointed. You've already said your piece and I have told you mine. I should go now.
Melba, please wait.
Come on, we had a deal. I listened to what you have to say, so now leave me alone.
If you really can't love me anymore, try not to resent me. It's all I ask of you. I beg of you, Melba.
Gardo, for our family's sake and our peace of mind, let's just forget about the past and each other because to me you're already dead.
Gigi.
I can't believe you have the nerve. You know that Gardo is a married man and yet you continue to seduce him.
What? Seduce him? Who seduced him first?
You've already left him. I just picked him up.
But then before I left him, you took him away from me. You just forced yourself on him. So just stop it. You're not the victim here. You're making me sick.
Gigi. That's enough.
So now you know how it feels. It hurts, doesn't it? Now take your husband home, Gigi. You can shove him down your throat.
Hey, Janice. You'll have your
what?
Medical exam later, right? If you want, I can go with you there.
Oh, no thanks. I mean, Wacky will go with me later. Oh, here he is.
Errol.
Thanks anyway. Oh, hey, you're a little early.
I don't want you to be late for your medical exam. Do you want to have dinner afterwards? But if you're too tired then, we can order takeout. We can eat at your place and have dinner with your parents.
Oh, no need. You can't go. You don't have to go to our house because, well, because we're having problems
at
home lately.
Because of me? Have I done something wrong?
No, not you. Oh, no. It's not because of you. It's
then
not...
Then what is it about?
About, well, my parents are just having a little, well, misunderstanding. You know how that goes.
Janice, these things happen in relationships. All right, then. Just tell me when it's okay to visit you at your house again. Okay?
Okay.
I loved you so much, Gardo. I served as your wife. I did everything for you. You wanted to forget Melba, remember? So I did everything to help you forget her.
All the letters I sent Melba came back unopened. I don't have any idea where to find her. I don't know.
Forget about Melba, Gardo. Gardo? May I talk to you for a minute?
What is it?
Gardo, I'm pregnant. I have given you everything I am. And I even devoted my whole life to you, Gardo.
Why didn't I devote my life to you, Gigi? Didn't I give everything that I have to you?
No, because your whole life and your heart, that's what he promised me, Gardo. So now tell me. Do you still love Melba? Do you still love Melba, Gardo?
Briggs?
Of planning, you know.
I just realized that it's so hard to keep a secret from you. You almost caught us.
Sorry, Rosalie. Sorry, Briggs.
I love you.
I love you too.
Mother.
Where have you been?
I went with Janice to the hospital for her checkup.
I want you to stay away from her. I don't want you to go out with her again, Wacky.
But why?
Because it's what I want. And you better do as I say.
Mother. Father.
Janice.
Mother, is there a problem?
No.
What?
I have something to tell you.
What is it?
It's what I told you about your father. That he died already. I lied to you.
What?
He's still alive, Janice.
So who is he?
He's Gardo Valdez.
But he's Wacky's father.
Yes, Janice. Wacky is your brother.
Wacky and I have the same father.
Gardo doesn't know about this. He doesn't know you are his daughter. When I came back home from Barcelona, only then did I find out I was pregnant. And I did not waste my time to inform him about you, because he's such a worthless person. And I've already decided that I will raise you on my own. So after that, I met your father. He was the one who somehow gave me back my life. He gave me new hope. I decided not to tell Gardo anything. That's because he cheated on me anyway. And I knew that he won't do you any good.
But doesn't he deserve the right to know?
What good would it do? He's married to someone else. He even has his own family now.
We had an agreement, Father, am I right? Yes, I'll go back to Barcelona, and I'll study there. But I will never break up with Janice. Besides, what's happening to Mother? Why is she so angry at Janice? Father, is there something going on?
It's so hard to explain, my son.
Please try. I'm willing to listen.
I'm sorry.
Excuse me.
Ara.
Why didn't you tell me about this?
About what, Mother?
I talked to Lee's father. He said that you were the one who was asking the congressman not to push through with a case against Melba.
If I didn't do that, then something bad might have happened to Jomar's family.
So tell me, how many times will you disobey me because of your boyfriend?
Jomar and I broke up, Mother.
After what you've done, do you think I'll still believe you?
Mother, I love Jomar. And that's the only reason why I broke up with him.
Unless you tell me that you're willing to leave the country, I will never believe that you have really broken up with him.
What do you mean, Mother?
Well, since your grandmother keeps on calling us, what do you say about paying her a visit? I've decided you won't finish your school here anymore. We will go back to Korea and stay there for good!
Why didn't you ask one of your cab drivers to fetch you?
I don't want to bother them anymore. There's another big problem back at home.
A problem?
My parents aren't talking to each other again.
What? Why? Has your father finally found out?
What? Found out what? What do you mean?
Oh, nothing. Nothing really.
Do you know something, Bricks?
Oh, come on. I don't know what you mean.
Are you looking for another fight?
Wait a minute. Hold on there.
Then don't keep secrets from me. You know that secrets annoy me.
But Luna...
And if I find out that you've been hiding something from me, I promise I'll break up with you. You're never going to see me again.
No, stop. Just wait. I'm just worried how you're going to take it. I'm just concerned about you.
How will I take what?
Wacky, I just realized that we'll be separated for a long time, right? You'll be leaving this week and I'll be following by next week. I'm just thinking, why don't we take a break from each
what?
Other? Oh, no. Well, what I'm trying to say is, let's stop seeing each other.
Please, Janice, not you two. Did my mother put you up to this?
Your mother? She has nothing to do with this at all. It's my decision.
Tell me what's happening to you. You're making me all confused, Janice.
I know it's crazy, Wacky.
So what do you really want? When are we going to meet up again? Before I leave?
No, we can't. I'm already breaking up with you. Let's end this.
What?
Paolo.
Oh, hi. Grandmother.
Will you accompany Wacky when he goes back to Barcelona?
I will. You know I have to.
Is it because of him?
No. It's not just because of him. It's also because I also need to find a...
better job that will let you earn more, so much more.
Mm-hmm.
But I'll have no one here with me. If you're leaving for Barcelona.
Come on, you know how my brother is, right? He'll be back right after I leave. Besides, I can't miss the chance of earning more money.
Well, if you're thinking that you'll be able to give me more comfort, because you'll be earning so much more back in Barcelona. But I'm going to be happier if you'll stay beside me. And besides my grandson, I don't think that I have much time left in this world. Will you please stay with me until the last hours of my life? We'll be able to survive without all that luxury. What matters most is that we are together.
My mother has decided that we're finally going back to Korea.
Actually, my grandmother's been trying to convince us to go back. And she thinks that now would be the right time.
That's fine, just go. Didn't I tell you before that you and I should just forget each other?
We're not coming back.
I know.
So remember this, Jomar. I'll never forget you. And whatever happens, you will always remain in my heart because you were once an important part of my life.
Errol, can we leave much earlier than our scheduled flight?
What's wrong? You and Wacky had a fight again?
No, it's just complicated. And it's something I just can't share with you. And all that's happened, I just want to escape all my problems.
All right, I'll talk to my aunt in Malaysia so that she can talk to our employers there. I'll just see, okay? All I know is that when they release our medical certificates, we can already leave for work anytime. I love you so much, Ara. That's why I can't let you leave.
I knew this would happen. I shouldn't have told you that I'm leaving.
Ara, please. Maybe we can do something to stop this.
It's too late. Everything has been arranged. And well, I also want to leave. I have too many problems here.
Is this about Jomar again? Ara, come on. You know that I can give whatever it is that he can give you, if there's any.
You're insecure. You're selfish. You're immature. Grow up, Lee. You can't hide behind the shadow of your father your whole life. Plus, you can't have everything you ask for. I'm not some object, Lee, that you can buy on a whim. And to answer your question, is this about Jomar? Even if I love Jomar so much, this is not about him. This is about you. Because I really don't love you. And you know, I don't think I ever will.
What's wrong?
Carlo, I want you to know that I will never give up Gardo to Melba.
And how will you do that? When your husband still loves Melba?
Because I am his legal wife. I will do anything to keep Gardo from leaving my side. Please help me.
How can my mother do this to us? I want to tell my father about this, but I know it will only make matters worse. I don't want our family to fall apart, Briggs. I don't think I can handle that.
But if you let your mother continue her relationship with Carlo, your family will surely fall apart.
Of course Wacky would surely be upset with you. I mean, how can you break up with him without telling him the real reason for it?
Lessie, I don't have the strength to tell him the truth. And besides, I promise Mother I won't tell him.
Is it your stomach again? Don't tell me you forgot to eat.
Well, how can I eat with all these things happening around us?
Come on then, let's go. Hurry up.
Janice.
Wacky. Please leave. Do not bother me now. I don't feel well.
Don't bother you now? Janice, you broke up with me and all you can say is I shouldn't bother you? Janice, tell me what's happening. I need to know the reason.
Wacky, please just leave.
Janice, I will not leave until you've given me a reasonable explanation. Janice, I need to know!
Will you please leave my daughter alone? She already told you to go away!
Mother...
Please tell me what I did wrong. Did I do something wrong? Have I offended anyone in your family?
Mother, that's
why are you mad?
Wacky,
mother,
just go away.
Wacky, Janice, please talk to me.
Go leave now, Wacky.
For goodness sake, leave her alone.
No, I'm not leaving.
Trouble.
Wacky, that's enough. Stop it. I had to break up with you because you're my brother.
You and I need to talk, Jomar.
Lee, I can't talk right now. My mind is mixed up.
What? Is there a brain in there?
I don't want any trouble.
It's all your fault. Because of you, I lost Ara. And that's why I want to hurt you. Plant my fist in your face, break every bone in your body.
Why don't you go ahead? But after you do that, what will you gain from it? Ara is still leaving, and we both lost her, Lee.
Even till the end? Ara told me that she still loves you. Even if it's against my will, I asked my father not to push through with the case against your mother. Because Ara promised that she'll leave you if I would help your family.
Ara did that for us? She broke up with me to save my family?
Yes! She did! She broke up with you, but she didn't come back to me. That's how deep her love is for you. She's that stupid. She made a fool out of me because of you. Because of you! Fight me, huh? Come on, Will! Help! Jomar, please. Please help me up. I'm begging you, please. Please help me. Jomar. Jomar, please. Please help me.
So why didn't you tell me the whole truth?
What truth? I don't know what you're talking about.
Why didn't you tell me you had a relationship with Janice's mother back in Barcelona?
How did you find out?
Melba actually told me herself, Father!
I didn't tell you because at that time, there was no need for you to know.
And the child you had with her?
What did you say?
And you didn't know? Janice is your daughter, Father!
What is going on here?
You should tell me, Mother, because I'm so confused. I don't know what's happening.
I feel something big is about to happen, especially now that Wacky knows the truth.
Mother, what do you plan to do?
I know you can decide what's best for you.
Melba, why did you keep this from me?
Gardo, please, not here.
Hold on. Junie, please go to your room.
Okay.
My child.
Let's go.
I'm so sorry. Are you Melba's husband?
Yes.
I just need to speak with Melba and Janice alone.
It's not the right time.
What do you mean this isn't the right time? You've kept this from me for long enough. You have already denied my rights to my very own daughter. Janice. If I only knew, I would have been there for you. Melba, if you had only told me, I would have come back home in an instant. I could have completed this family.
Gardo, it's too late for regrets. Our family is complete. Don't try to break us apart.
No, I do not intend to break your family apart. All I want for now is to at least have a connection or be a part of her life. There is so much I will have to make up to her, and I know I could have given her my love.
Gardo, there is really nothing that I need from you. Because any voice that you've left with me has been filled in by my father. He has filled it with so much love. But you really shouldn't worry. I know I owe you my life, that I'm here because of you.
I just hope that you'll accept that this man beside me is my father.
Ara?
Jomar?
Ara, I know what you have done.
I'm sorry, Jomar. I had to do it.
Ara, you have saved my whole family. I'm really sorry for all that I've said. I know I was wrong, Ara. I'm so sorry. But Ara, you should know that I have never stopped loving you.
Me too. I never stopped loving you.
Do you really have to leave for Korea?
Yes. But I want you to promise me one thing. That you won't forget that you loved me. And when I come back, promise that you'll still be here.
I promise, Ara. I promise you.
Ara! Get in the car right now.
I will never be able to forgive you for as long as I know that you love Melba. I am still your wife, and we have two children. We made a life together, just the two of us along with our children. That's why I can never let a complete stranger come into our lives. That will never happen.
What's wrong with you? Can't you forget everything that has happened in the past? Mother, father, it's not easy to forget Janice. It's not easy for me to accept that we can't be together. But I'll try to do it. Just for the sake of our family. I want our family to be happy again.
Janice, you have a visitor.
Let's leave them for a while so they can talk.
How are you doing?
It hurts to know the truth. You know, I have so many questions in my mind. But I know that whatever I do, I can't change a thing. Maybe that's why I'll just imitate your attitude when it comes to these problems. I can do this.
Okay, then I can do this too, Wacky.
I hate my mother. She even had the nerve to tell my father that she won't let anyone destroy our family. I mean, at least my father was honest about his feelings. But my mother? I hate her.
Here, have a drink.
Not now.
You know what, Luna? I'm sure you can't stay angry with your mother forever. You'll have to find a way to fix it.
But how?
Why don't you ask for some help from your older brother? I think that you should tell him the truth. And then, maybe the two of you can solve that problem with your mother.
Errol, Santiago,
Here. Here's your medical certificate. Now, who is Plessy Padilla?
Oh, sir, that's me.
Well, here is your certificate.
Thank you so much.
Some thing for Janice Concepcion?
Janice?
Results.
Can I talk to you in private?
What? Oh, no, sir, it's okay. We can talk here. What is it?
It's about your medical examination. You weren't able to pass.
Huh? What? But, doctor, is there a problem?
It's a problem with your stomach.
Oh, yes, I do have that, doctor. Am I right? That's just hyperacidity or maybe some ulcers. I usually experience some stomach pains, but then that usually comes and goes.
I fear the problem with your stomach is not that simple, my dear.
Is it really that bad?
It's really bad.